Welcome to the Dollar Box, and today I want to talk about one of the most controversial topics yet. Let's face it, the post office has been inept for years, and that's why I think Amazon will take over not just delivering your packages, but delivering your mail too. What makes me believe that Amazon will be delivering the mail as well as packages in the future? I'll tell you why. Prime subscriptions. They would certainly be faster, more efficient, and have better customer service than the US Postal Service does. Before we go any further, please like and subscribe this video. Leave a comment. I would love to hear your feedback on this idea. I truly believe one of the biggest reasons the post office has never really had a competitor is because the infrastructure is almost impossible to create. The logistics of having distribution centers and mail trucks and delivery people and all this, it's a huge undertaking to try to get to basically every home in America, even the ones that don't live anywhere near anyone else. However, I believe Amazon has that infrastructure or is very close to it. For example, in my town, they recently purchased a distribution center from a retailer that's gone out of business, and they are now using all their own vans, their own fleet of vehicles, to deliver packages to all the houses in my area. Not a few hours go by before I see another Prime delivery van. The Prime vans is what we call them around here. As a matter of fact, yesterday there were actually two in my cul-de-sac at the same time. Now there's only five houses in my cul-de-sac. There was one delivering to my neighbor and one delivering on the other end of the cul-de-sac. And I saw both of them leave together. So tell me how much harder it would be for them to simply be the distribution center where our mail goes. They throw the mail in the trucks with the packages, and then that gets delivered as well. The reason I think they would do it for free is due to subscription money. I think they would require you to have a Prime membership and then you would get free delivery. Even if you're not someone who buys a lot of stuff from Amazon or uses their streaming services, most of us would see value in being able to get our mail back and forth for free. They may offer to deliver anybody's mail, even without a Prime subscription, but then you would have to pay for that postage. Would they keep it the same as the Postal Service? Would it go up? Would it go down? I don't know. That's something that would have to be in their grand structure, and they'd have to figure out what that means for them. But in order for them to gain even more customers, which Amazon, the percentage of people that use Amazon, I think, is like 58%, 60%. Will people use it? Would they not use it? Would they complain? Do people want to keep the institution of the Postal Service alive? I don't know. I mean, there's other factors at play here. It's not just a normal one business taking over another business. And the other factor to it is the Postal Service was always seen as just that, a service to the American people. It wasn't seen as an extension of a for-profit company. So that might cause some problems. However, the US Postal Service has not kept up their end of the bargain in recent times. They've had struggles with politics, which it shouldn't be involved in politics at all. It also has problems with customer service. The mail times are bad, the prices are too expensive, packages go missing. For example, even the truck that's delivering the mail in my area, you can hear it coming a mile away. They don't do the maintenance, they don't do the upgrades, and they have these giant pensions that they're trying to pay out for employees that haven't worked there for a long time, and they just don't, financially, they aren't successful. So that's why I believe Amazon will eventually be our mail carrier, as well as our package carrier. Now, why this would be great for sports cards, of course, is most of the transactions that are being done these days are online, via different websites or even person-to-person or Facebook, things like that. That would help us a ton to get our cards back and forth efficiently as well as at the best price. So what do you think? Leave a comment down below. Let me hear it. I would love to see what everybody else thinks of this idea. And thanks for watching.